Thanks for dropping in. Gift cards. I love getting these, but I'm a bit hesitant about actually giving them. Even when a card is ideal for a recipient, I worry the giftee will think it's a thoughtless last-second purchase. Maybe gift cards are just a little too convenient for their own good. So this week, I'm releasing a 3D printed model that adds some effort and pizzazz to the act of giving gift cards. This is the pop-up gift card box. You just slide off the decorative band and raise the lid. As the box opens, the gift card flips around and lifts into the air for maximum drama. Here's the part that's doing all the work. You might recognize this as a single link from a scissor mechanism, the sort of hinge found in scissor lifts and extending toys. All I needed to do was size the mechanism down to fit a standard gift card. Simple, right? I definitely didn't burn through a bunch of failed prototypes in this week's project. The box itself can be printed in two parts, or all at once with a print-in-place hinge. I like how the print-in-place version just barely touches the build plate before dramatically branching out. Also, these 45-degree layer lines would be great for mid-print color swaps. If you plan to try this print-in-place version, make sure your printer is sufficiently tuned to easily handle clearances of 0.25 millimeters or less. Otherwise, the pin that holds the hinge together will fuse and keep the box in a permanently open state. I consider trying print-in-place hinges for the scissor mechanism as well, but that would require chunkier hinges. So instead, I decided to use one of my favorite tricks. Scrap filament hinges. The 2.2 millimeter holes that run through each hinge should be wide enough to accept 1.75 millimeter filament, but still tight enough to keep the filament in place. Your prints may vary though, so a drop of superglue or a small drill bit may be necessary if the holes come out too loose or too tight. I have all the parts here for another box, so let's get to assembling. When building the prototypes, I found it easiest to assemble the scissor mechanism last. It's just easier to connect these longer sections to the box before there's all this other stuff in the way. This part with the spindly arms is the bottom latch. We'll insert two pieces of filament into these bottom hinges, but only push them in about halfway. Now we'll snap the latch into whichever side of the box you want to be the bottom. Technically it works either way, but one side just looks more like a lid to me. Using a pair of needle nose pliers, push the filament the rest of the way into the hinge. There may be a bit of excess filament left. At the end of the assembly, we'll trim that off. If you leave it on now, you'll have something to grab onto if you notice a mistake during the rest of the assembly process. This is something I found out the hard way. The top latch connects to the lid the exact same way. Make sure this slope on this top piece is pointing away from the box, or the scissor mechanism won't close. Yeah, I messed that one up too. Now we're going to connect these two main latches. You can try threading filament all the way through the entire hinge. Or, if that's causing problems, you can use two smaller bits of filament on either end. Just make sure they're long enough to get a good grip on the inside. This middle latch goes next. It sits right inside the top latch. If everything's been assembled correctly so far, this middle latch will be able to rest on the slope from the top latch. Next, we're going to add this holder latch. It's the part that clamps onto the gift card. It connects to both the bottom latch and the middle latch that we just connected. Now test the hinge a little, and if everything looks good, clean up any stray bits of filament. If any of the filament is loose, now's the best time to add glue or heat to really seal up those hinges. Okay, we've got a working box. But what'll make this gift special is customizing it. This design has a few parts you can pick and choose from. Two different bases, one plain and one with a diamond pattern, as well as four different bands. Thin, wide, snowflake, and flower. Using modeling software, you can easily emboss your own design on the band, on the box, or even on the latch. I'm constantly amazed by all the creative remixes I've seen for past products, so I'm excited to see where people take this design. If you decide to share a print or a remix, let me know. I'd love to see it. But that's it for this design. So, until next week, happy printing, and thanks for stopping by.